As you may have heard, YouTube.com bought Twitch.tv, and this week they started imposing some changes to the website. First, on Monday, they ended up shutting down a website known as JustinTV. This is the first live stream startup attempt that was started by the Twitch TV team, and it was essentially Justin. He started live streaming his own life and people can tune in, and then other people started live streaming, like iJustine was one of the first people to join JustinTV and do some live streaming there. But it really started to turn into a copyright streaming machine, and a lot of the content being live streamed was not actually owned by the people streaming to JustinTV, and it was shut down on Monday. And I guess that's kind of to be expected after the Google purchase of Twitch TV, but on Tuesday, Twitch TV added some sort of a new audio detection service to their VOD system. And if you don't know what a VOD system is, it's video on demand, so you can watch previous live streams that have already happened in the past. So if, say you wanted to catch Swifty live streaming yesterday, but you didn't have time, you could go back to his channel and go to his videos and watch yesterday's live stream, and there's no issues with that, in the past anyway. But now, they have audio detection, so if they find a copyrighted song, like say you used a copyrighted song on YouTube, it would flag the video and you would have to either acknowledge that you used a copyrighted song in the video or dispute it. Well, with Twitch, what they decided to do for some reason is completely cut out all of the audio when that song is playing in the background. So if you played Eminem in the background of your stream and it detected that song of Eminem's and behind you when you're talking on your microphone, it would mute the entire segment that that song was playing in the background, even yourself when you're talking through the microphone. So naturally, the whole Twitch community is out in arms with their pitchforks and torches. But I really want to know what you guys think in the comment section down below. I'm going to give you my opinion, which is I think this is a great change. And a lot of you are going to be like, what are you talking about? Well, I think what they're trying to do is protect the live streamer. If you look at Michelle Phan, for example, she is a big YouTube star in the makeup section of YouTube, and she's being sued for $7.5 million because she used songs in the backgrounds of her videos over the course of however old her channel is, and they claim that they are owed royalties for these songs that are in their videos, and it's really unfortunate to see, but she didn't get any sort of permission for these songs, and they might have some sort of a legal ground here, and she actually might lose a lot of money. So I think what they're trying to do is protect the live streamer at the end of the day, and I think it's a good change. So again, I'm really curious about what you guys think in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. I've been Alex Adams, senior manager at Freedom, and you've been watching...
Click the first video for a fireside chat with George, where he shares our future and how we grew from $20,000 to $120,000 in just 1 month. And click the second video to see how to monetize all of your videos with just a few clicks to enable all ad formats and monetize in all countries. And we will grow together as a family, because this is the Freedom Family. You are part of it, we are all part of it, and we're all growing together. So grow with us and partner with Freedom. That Play Now button right there on the video bar is all you need to click to get started.
Your secrets, if you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays.